Well, why does it have to go wrong when everything was so good? We were so happy.
Does Ian know?
No.
Well, then what's the problem? Is he dead set against children?
Well, we've never even discussed having a family. I presume because he'd been married for 6 years without having any children that he didn't want any.
Well, that's one hell of an assumption.
Well, you heard what he said outside the workshop.
Look, he was only joking with women. You don't have to take that to heart. How do you feel about having children?
Well, whenever I've thought about marriage, I've presumed that I would have children.
Then I think it's time you talk to Ian.
I know. I just want to be certain.
It'll be all right. You see?
Yeah, and if it isn't?
It's Dava. Now's as good a time as any to ask her. Oh, hello, Mrs. Davidson.
Hello, Lizzie. Have you started Bee's cake yet?
No, I've been cleaning the vegetables for the stew. I haven't had a chance to do anything else.
Well, the party's not until tomorrow. It might be better if it's fresh.
But I thought that's why we were sent in here. Not that I'm complaining.
Don't worry, there's plenty of time. And I'll arrange for you to have an extra tin of ham for the sandwiches.
Oh, that's very good of you, Mrs. Davidson.
Mrs. Davidson, there was something else we wanted to ask you.
Yes?
We were wondering if we could send Bea a singing telegram.
I've got a bloke that...
A singing telegram? I don't see why not. It could be quite a novelty.
Well, if I could just make a phone call...
Oh, that won't be necessary. I'll book the telegram myself, so we can be sure it will arrive.
Oh, but Mrs. Davidson...
Oh, and Lizzie, I thought you might like to know that Mr. Marnie has come back for one last day.
She knows that I've fixed it to get him back in. Now I won't have a chance of seeing him at all.
That won't be the only thing you don't get a chance to see.
The stripper.
You can be sure old Davo won't be phoning the chappie I had in mind.
Oh, that's another idea that's gone for nothing.
You know, I think we could handle it ourselves now.
You know, I got a funny feeling I wasn't really needed here.
Oh, maybe they just wanted your body.
I'm sorry, that's taken.
Oh, well, somebody should have told Lizzie.
Yeah.
Hey, where is she today?
In the kitchen.
No, that's a pity. Now, look, is there anything else you need for this paper, Ewens?
Yeah, come to think of it, we could use some larger typeface, you know, for newspaper headlines. Uh-huh. What we got's fine for pamphlets, but not good for the paper.
I think I've got some old typeface at home. It may not be a complete set, so you might have to limit some of your headlines, but you're welcome to have it.
Oh, that's great, but when do we get it?
Yeah, paper's supposed to be out in 2 days, you know.
Of course, we understand that you're a very busy man.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I will go home at lunchtime and get the typeface.
Right? Yay! Oh, that's great.
We really appreciate it, don't we, girls?
Oh, she appreciates it.
More good news, ladies. Your friend Myra Desmond's got another job for you.
Oh, what is it?
A bowling club newsletter.
Oh, that's not going to be worth much.
Well, no, but it's a monthly newsletter.
You mean it'll be a regular job?
If you don't print anything upside down.
Well, we'll have to keep a certain person away from it then, huh?
Okay. Here's the copy and the layout.
Yeah.
Oh.
Mr. Marnie?
Yes, Susie?
Did you know my mum's in here now?
Your mother?
Yeah.
That's got to be on the inside front.
Wondering where you were.
Why?
Well, I'm afraid I'll have to skip our lunch date. I promised I'd go home and get some typeface for the prison paper.
Oh, well, doesn't matter.
You're not mad at me, are you?
Why should I be?
Well, you weren't too pleased about me coming in today. Oh,
I'll forget all about it. I just wasn't feeling very chirpy this morning. I guess I didn't want to have to share you with this place any more than I have to.
Well, after today, you won't have to share me with anything.
Good.
So you have to work in the governor's office for the send-off?
Fine. See you then.
Rotten luck, Judy. Old Davo's agreed to the telegram.
Hey, that's great.
Shh. Yeah. Sorry. So what's wrong with that?
She's going to book it herself.
Oh, well, that's big of her, isn't it?
Why can't she book it through your friend?
Are you kidding?
Must have been.
Come on.
Mrs. Morris, where's Jo?
She had her meal at the First City. She must have been hungry. Where are you going, Susie? You haven't finished your lunch yet.
Oh, I'm not hungry, thanks.
Connie, did you leave any really good stuff?
That poor kid. Wish there was something we could do to help her.
Like what?
Yeah, I know. There's probably nothing we can do.
Maybe. Maybe not.
What do you mean, B?
What Susie's mother did to her was inexcusable. Abandoning her when she was a kid, deserting her to a life of institutions. And let's just say she did turn up in Wentworth. She'd be pretty smart to keep quiet about it, right?
Yeah, otherwise she'd have to face us.
Right.
But do you reckon that Joe is Susie's mother?
Oh, I don't know. All I'm saying is, if I was her, I wouldn't let on either.
Spader, they were a bit unhappy when you told them what happened.
Yeah, Doreen's given me an idea.
Oh, she's a bright little kid sometimes. What'd she say?
Well, it's not actually what she said. She just said to get David to ring my friend to do the telegram.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson would never do that. She'd book a proper company.
Yeah, but there can't be too many of those.
So what?
Well, shouldn't be too hard finding out which one she rang.
Oh, she'd never do that.
Look, all I have to do is find the right one, when I found it, cancel the telegram, and then get my bloke to come and do it.
Oh, yeah. Now be the expecting the one Mrs. Davidson booked, and your bloke will just walk straight in.
That's the plan. What's the matter? You don't like the idea?
Yeah, it's great. And it doesn't solve my problem.
Oh, yeah? And what's your problem?
Oh, I can manage this. There's another one over there.
Oh, you don't think I'm going to lift that all on my own, do you? Now, what's this problem of yours?
Well, I went to all that trouble to try and get Mr. Marnie back, and now I'm not even going to be able to say goodbye.
Yeah. That's a pity.
Pity? It's criminal. I know, but it still doesn't seem fair. Oh! Ouch! Mr. Marnie! Bagger it!
Missed him again, eh?
Oh, yeah. But I got an idea.
Well, help me with this bin.
Oh, there's no time for that.
But Lizzie...
There's another bin in there. Now come along and give us a hand with it.
Lizzie.
It's all right for some, isn't it? Have a look at this pair over here.
We've done our share, we love.
Damn right we have.
What have you two been up to?
You'll find out.
What have you done, Lizzie?
I'm not telling.
Lizzie.
I don't think she wants to tell us, Pete.
Oh, she's just playing games.
All right, come on, Helen.
My lips are sealed.
Give us a clue, please.
Well, what do you reckon, Helen?
I'll give him a clue.
Well, all I can say, you'll be looking out the window at the front gate when the screws knock off work. And I'm not telling you another thing.
What have you done?
I reckon she's having his own.
No, she isn't.
So, whilst it's sad to say goodbye to someone we've grown to like, it does have its compensations. We would all like to wish Janet and Ian every happiness in the future. Janet.
Speech, speech, come on.
We know it was a speech, Steve.
Go on, I meant from one of you. Come on, Janet.
No. Look, nothing from me.
Ignore him, darling. He's a masochist. Mrs. Davidson, ladies and gentlemen, we'd just like to say thank you all for your kind words and most of all, thank you, Wentworth, for the future, Mrs. Marnie.
Oh,
very good.
How does it feel now?
Nervous.
Well, that's a good sign.
What do you mean by that?
Well, that's how I felt. The first time.
I'm going to miss you, Meg.
Not very often, and not for very long. What will Ian to keep your hands full?
Oh, well, we'll argue about that at the wedding.
Listen, I must go before they all go over the wall. Yeah. I'll see you in a couple of days.
Bye, Ian.
Thanks, Meg.
Yes, just a minute. Janet, it's for you.
Oh, thank you.
Well, you give Janet me some good advice.
Well, no, he's giving me some, actually.
Oh.
He's known Janet under rather different circumstances.
I was really trying to persuade him to stay.
Thank you. I think he'll be far too busy to be thinking about us.
I'll be thinking.
You all right, Janet?
Yes. I just don't like goodbyes.
Well, then we'll make it quick, eh? Okay, goodbye, everybody. Thanks again.
Careful, mate, she's got you under her thumb already. Look after
yourself.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Boom, 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 boom.
Doctor.